A very good morning, my dear student. And in today's video, I have started your chapter 3, that is your agreement of the verb with the subject of your unit 3, that is your grammar application. And after completion of this video, you will able to know where you will be using your singular verb and when to use your plural verb. So, now my first question is, what is your singular verb? Now your singular verbs are is, was, has, and your plural verb are, were, have. So in this chapter you will be knowing when you will be using your singular verb and what are the rules you should keep in mind while you will be using your plural verb. Okay, so the first rule says two singular subject connected by or either or neither nor requires a singular verb. Okay, so rule number one says when two singular subject means when two singular means aunt, uncle. Here student look, aunt here is a first singular subject, another singular subject is your uncle. Okay, so when two singular subject, that is your uncle and aunt, is connected by words such as or, either or, neither nor, requires a singular verb. So you can see here student, I have written one example. My aunt or my uncle is arriving by train today. So here two singular noun are connected by the word or. So as per the rule, it will be your singular verb. And your singular verb is. Okay? Now look to another example. Neither Juan nor Carmen is available. Okay? So here again your two singular noun. One is your Juan and another one is Carmen. These are the two singular subject which is connected by neither nor. So and your, you will be using singular verb, that is your is. Okay, now rule number two says when subject connected by or nor are different numbers, the verb is plural. Okay, so when your subject, in first case it says that if two singular noun is connected by or nor, either or, neither nor, the sub, your verb will be singular. But in another case it says that when the subject are connected by or nor are different in number. Okay, different in number means here see, neither the principal nor teachers dash present. Here it will be your plural verb because teachers is your plural. Okay, so your verb will also be plural. That is, answer is your where. Okay, so when there is a two singular noun connected by or nor, either or, neither nor, is your singular. But when your two singular noun connected by or nor but are different in number, okay, these are different in number s, then you will be using plural verb. Next, when two or more singular subject connected by and usually take a verb in plural. So when two or more singular subject is connected by your word and, okay, agar and se connection rahega, two singular subject is connected by the word and, your verb will be plural. Example, Ram and Shyam are good friends. Understood? When two subject, singular subject are connected by and, then you will be using your plural verb. Okay? Now rule, next rule. Two singular noun refer to same person or thing, the verb must be singular. Okay, what it is saying? Two singular noun refer to same person. Example, the poet and dramatist is dead. Okay, now singular poet, dramatist poet, but it refer to one single person. How you will know that here the poet and dramatist is referring to one single person? By the help of the word the. Okay, the poet and the dramatist is dead refers here to one single person, because here the means it is referring to one person, who is your poet as well as your dramatist who is dead. Okay, so when two singular noun is referring to same person, here noun is poet and dramatist and it is referring to same person, how you will know it is the same person? By the help of word the, then your verb will be singular. Okay, but when two singular noun referring to two different person, your verb will be plural. Okay, your verb will be plural. And how you will know that they are different person? Look here, by the help of your article the. Here it has written the poet and the dramatist are dead. Okay, in first case what was there? The poet. Here look, the poet and dramatist. Here only the, there is only one the, means it is one single person. Okay, jo person tumhara poet hai, jo person dramatist hai, is dead. He is one single person. But here you look student, the poet and the dramatist refer to two different person. Okay, how? Because the is used twice, so it is referring to two different person. And when it is referring to two different person, your verb will be plural verb. Okay, next, if two subject together express one idea, they may be in the singular. So when two subject express together one single idea, example, bread and jam is my favorite breakfast. Okay, they are two different subject, one is bread, another is jam, but together they are giving one single idea, that is your is my favorite breakfast. In this case you will be using singular verb. Now next, if the singular subject are preceded by each, every, the verb is singular. Okay, whenever your subject, subject ke aage, preceded matlab subject ke aage each hai ya every hai, as per the rule you will be using singular verb. Now what is your singular verb? That is your was. Okay, next, some noun which are plural in form but singular in meaning take singular verb. Okay, kya bol raha hai? Sometime what happens student, there are certain words which is plural in form, okay, which are plural in form but they are singular in meaning. Example, news, mathematics, economics, physics, these are SS. Okay, physics, mathematics, politics, these are plural in form but they are singular in meaning, so your verb will be singular. Understood? They are plural in form but singular in meaning, so the verb will be singular. Example, the news is true. Understood? Mathematics is a difficult subject. Okay, so whenever some there are certain noun which are plural in form but singular in meaning, your verb will be singular. Moving ahead, words joined to a singular subject by, with, together with, in addition to, or as well as, verb is singular. Now what does it means? It means that when singular subject, samajh mein aaya, do singular subject joined by your words, kya kya words se joined rahenge? With, together with, in addition to, as well as, or will be your singular verb. Example, see, the principal with all the teachers was present at the meeting. Here, with all. So, by the rule, as your rule says, when two singular subject connected by your word with, together with, in addition to, as well as, your verb will be singular. Okay? Next rule says, when the plural noun is a proper name for some single object or some collective unit, it must be singular verb. Okay? So, whenever there is a single object or some collective unit, but it is referring to one single thing, then you will be using singular verb. Example, Arabian Nights is an interesting collection of stories. Arabian Night is your proper name, but it reflects single object, that is, it is a storybook, and so it is a singular verb. Got it? Your object is your plural name, that is your Arabian Night, and it is reflecting to a single object, that it is a storybook, and it is a singular verb. Last rule, when the plural noun denotes some specific quantity or amount considered as a whole, the verb is singular. Koi bhi specific quantity, if your sentence is dealing with specific quantity or amount, then your verb will be singular. Example, 100 paise is equal to a rupees. Okay, whenever there is a specific quantity or amount, you will be using singular verb. So, I hope all these rules which I taught you just now went into your mind and which will be very fruitful for you while you are using a subject verb agreement, or when you are using a singular verb or plural verb. Okay, thank you.